Hey everybody, welcome back to Aloma Kids Online and for our third week of Wise Up. If you guys are looking for some more resources or things to do with your kids, we want to invite you to check out www.alomachurch.org/kids or check out our Aloma Family YouTube channel.
That's right, there's a lot of great stuff on there for the whole family to enjoy, but this coming Thursday, July 30th, man, we want to let you know we're having our Aloma Kids drive-through. This is just something to get the whole family out of the house before everybody goes crazy. We know it's happening. So here's what we're going to do. Thursday, right up here out in front of the Boatwright Center, we want you to swing by anytime between 5 p.m. and 7 p.m. Here's what we're doing. We're going to have some Jeremiah's Italian Ice, some ice cream so you can make some gelatis. Is that what they are? Yeah, gelato, something like that. Anyway, but you can have fun. We can mix and match and all that stuff. And we're going to have the Dunk-a-Pastor dunk tank.
Oh, okay? That's my favorite.
So it's going to be a lot of fun. I know. Now, listen, this is all contactless. You're going to drive up. You're going to tell us what kind of Italian ice or ice cream or mix that you would like. We're going to give that right to you. Everybody in the family gets one. It's going to be awesome. And then you can drive over to the dunk tank. Instead of using the dunk tank balls, right, we're going to ask the kids some questions. Every question that you get right is a time that one of our folks hits the little button to dunk a pastor. So you can dunk myself, Pastor Rob. Who knows? We might even get some celebrity pastors coming out. Yeah, there you go. That might be fun. So that's this Thursday from 5 to 7 p.m., July 30th, right here in front of the Boatwright Center. Hope you guys are there.
Yeah, that sounds super fun, and I hope to see all of you there. But talking about this kind of puts me in like a gamey mood, so I think it's game time.
Let's do it. All right, that's awesome. Okay, so we've kind of had our gamers here at Aloma Kids, and so once again, we're going to call up Gianna and Maya. Give it up for them. Yeah. Woo. I can't hear you. Louder, louder, louder.
Okay, come on up here, guys.
Anyway, come on up, guys. How you guys doing today?
Doing great.
Great. Come on over here so they can all see your faces. Look at that. Nice. So last week, we asked about your favorite animals, I think, right?
Yeah.
So this week, we're going to learn something new about you guys, right? Okay, so here we go. So I want you to introduce yourself, and then I want you to tell everybody out there what your favorite smell is.
Okay. I'm Gianna, and my favorite smell is the pizza smell.
All right. Gianna loves the pizza smell. I know that smell well. It's really good. All right. Ready? Here you go.
My name is Maya, and my favorite smell would be the burger smell.
Okay, Maya has got the burger. I see the trend here. It's food, which actually, mine's kind of bacon, so that would... Yeah,
nice
so that's
coffee.
Good. Anyway, so we have a very special game for you today, kind of a new game that we're going to play. What's going to happen is I'm going to give each of you a pair of nylon stockings. Yes, okay, that's amazing right there. So we're going to get that and give you a pair as well. Now, here's the deal. What I did is down in the bottom of each stocking, right, I put a penny. So just a little guy kind of thing. So there's one on each side. Now, the name of the game is to get the penny out of the bottom of the stocking, okay? First one to do that, both sides wins. Fairly easy, not a big deal, right? You only have 1 minute to do it, though, and here's the catch, because there's always a catch, right, guys? Do this at home, it's great, because you can wrap up your brother, and he'll never get out. Anyway, so here's what you're going to do. We're going to take your hands, and we're going to put them in there, and we're going to put them behind your back. And so you got to do this behind your back. Cool?
Make it tricky.
Yeah, I like it. Okay, so let me help you out. We're going to get these in here. Here you go, right? Turn around, put one in there, one in there. Yeah, okay, ready? You got that? Okay. So, that looks great. Yeah, man. This is the only time you're not going to look at the camera. You're going to turn your backs to the camera so that they can see the craziness that ensues. All right, you ready? We're going to get started. Give it a countdown, guys. Ready? 3, 2, 1, get going. Let's see what you got. Come on, you got this. That's good. Stretch it. Stretch.
Wow.
Stretch. You got this.
You got
this. Oh, the faces. The faces. Oh, they're almost down to the bottom. How far are we? Okay, you're not doing too bad.
Hey, good,
no, Jenna, you got this. Go down, get down. Maya's down there. She's almost to the bottom. She's so
that's
close.
So difficult.
You feel the penny. Just a little guy. She's down in there. Hey, come on, you got this.
Come on.
You got this. You got it. Keep on going. Oh, oh, stretch. It's all good. I didn't. You wouldn't be able to sleep tonight. All right, keep going. Keep going.
30
you got
seconds.
This. You got this. Get that thing. Get the penny. Oh my gosh, we're already down to 25 seconds. Come on. You got this. Come on. Oh my goodness. No, you're losing it. Now you're losing it. You're getting further. Oh, okay. You got one. Come on. Oh, you got 17. Get out of there. Oh, you're down to 12. Get out of there. Come on. Oh, wow. That was so close. Both of them got it. I think Maya got it just by like a half a second. So our winner. Hey, wait a minute. You won last week too, didn't you? Oh, dude. Oh, man. Gianna, all right, we'll see what happens next week. Give them a great big round of applause. Make sure you try it at home. And if you're willing, yeah, send us the video of you doing it at home. All right? Sounds good. Thanks, guys, for praying today.
Good job, you guys. That was such a crazy game.
Thanks.
Speaking of crazy, though, it's almost time to check in with our friends Jordan and Zippy at the craziest school you've ever seen.
That's true. But before we do, all right, I have another memory verse for us. So hopefully you guys have been memorizing. Our first one is found in Proverbs chapter 1, verse 5. But this week, I'd like us to take a look at another proverb. It's found in chapter 13, verse 4. And it simply says this: the lazy will not get what they want, but those who work hard will. So I want you guys to remember that verse, all right? Take a look at it, start working on it, all right?
You know, that verse goes perfectly with what our main point is today, and it is, I will work hard.
Ah, that's perfect. So I tell you what, everybody on your feet, we're going to memorize and do our main point for today. We kind of need some motions for this, right? So,
of course.
Cass, would you do some motions for us?
I would be honored.
Okay, so what do we do? Let's just start with I, right? So
I.
Okay, that's easy. I, and then will.
Will.
Ooh, strong will. Okay, so I will, and then work.
Work.
Work, of course.
Hammering wood.
And then hard. Very good. Some of you have very hard heads. I know you. Okay, parents. Anyway, okay, so I will work hard. So everybody standing on your feet, right? I want you to repeat after me as loud as you can and follow the motions along with Miss Cass, all right? Here we go. So ready? Everybody.
I
will
work
hard.
Hard.
Not bad. All right, but we need to make sure that the neighbors hear it, right?
True.
Okay, so let's try this again. I want you guys to be really loud. If your parents are sitting behind you on the couch, tell them they need to participate. Yes, get up off the couch. Here we go. Ready? Repeat after me. I
will
work
hard.
Nice job, guys. Very good. I tell you what, while we're all standing, we need to do some singing and dancing for Jesus. So all of y'all stay up. Let me actually get, I know your ankles are still kind of, yeah, pray for Cassie's ankles. But let's bring up Ashley. Ashley and I are going to do one of our banner songs here at Aloma Kids. Man, we've done this for eons, man. So I'll tell you what, parents, you help us out. This is a simple one. All we do is just bounce. So you ready to bounce? All right, let's do this. DJ Rob, kick it, brother.
Safe in the Savior's hands. You were more than your sun down and set me free. Everything of this world will fade. I'm pressing on till I see your face. I will live that your will be done. I won't stop till your kingdom come.
Tired of having to walk up 15 flights of stairs. Don't they know how hard it is to walk? Ugh, I mean, it's awful.
I know. Why couldn't our elevator class come down and, like, pick us up? But we had to walk up the stairs, and I don't like it.
It's hard work. I mean, even at home, right? Like, my mom, I'll come home from a hard day at school, and then she's like, hey, you need to wash the dishes. I'm like, ugh. Hey, you need to walk the dogs. I'm like, ugh. I just don't get it.
I know. In our class, even in our class, we had to do pointless assignments like writing a word over and over and over again.
Oh, man. Speaking of hard work, now we gotta feed this guy. He's so far away. Look at that.
Nose goes.
Oh. Are you serious, Jordan?
Yes. Go feed him.
He's so far away. Why can't he just feed himself?
Good morning, class! I see that you are all in your seats and ready to work hard today because, wait for it, we're going on a field trip! And your special field day lunch menu is broccoli pizza, pickles, and spinach pudding! All mixed into one big milkshake! Yum! We also have some fantastic field trip wise words. Today's wise words are from Proverbs 13:4. Here's how they say you can wise up. The lazy will not get what they want, but those who work hard will. To help you practice working hard and not being lazy, I have a special assignment for you. You may notice the waterproof paper in the classroom. Your assignment is to cover everything in the classroom with it, including yourselves. When you finish, we'll go on a field trip.
Well, I guess since Mrs. Wise was talking about hard work, we should probably feed Eduardo.
Where's the waterproof paper Miss Wise was talking about? There it is. But I don't understand why she wants us to waterproof the whole classroom. It's hard work, and I don't want to do it.
I totally agree, Jordan. I mean, She must not realize how big this classroom is. To wrap everything, it's going to take forever, and it seems pointless.
I know, but if Miss Wise wants us to waterproof the whole class, then I guess we should.
Yeah, you're right. I guess on the bright side, I've never actually wrapped anyone in waterproof paper before, so are you ready for this?
I guess as ready as I'll ever be.
Oh, yeah, here we go. Hold on to that for me. Yep. Huh? Go. Spin. Nice. All right, right there, we're good. All right, so you gonna do me now?
I guess so. Hold this for me. And we're going around and around and around. And, I think that's good enough.
All right.
Wait, maybe one more. There we are.
Perfect.
Perfecto mundo.
All right, class, it's time for our field trip. Everyone grab your goggles and swim ring. I hope you're ready to go.
Oh no, I don't have my floaties or my goggles.
Relax, Jordan. I mean, everyone knows that the elevator doesn't move until the lights flash.
Oh, I don't even have my goggles!
Here, take that. I got you. Put that on. Okay, I got mine. Okay, we gotta hurry up. Wait, you're too close.
Stay on your side. Ooh, stay on your side. Gosh. Get out of my spot.
Whoa. Look at this place. You know what? In the future, I'm definitely going to surf on top of my desk when the classroom's moving.
Speaking of surfing, we're in an aquarium.
Oh, man. It all makes sense now. This is amazing. Like, I always knew that the 11th floor smelled fishy, and now I know why. It's because there's an aquarium in it.
Hey, look at all these fish. Do you think they know we're here?
Oh, man. Dude, this is crazy. Because of the waterproof tape, I'm not even getting wet. This is amazing.
I get it now. Miss Wise's method to madness is actually not madness. It makes more sense, because if we didn't do it, our whole classroom would be wet.
You are so right.
Wow. Oh, hello. I hope you're enjoying your field trip here on the aquarium floor. I usually come here to do my daily swimming exercises. You know, you get a much better workout when you're being chased by a shark. Well, I hope everything is going well for you on your field trip. We've had some mishaps on field trip day in the past. In fact, last year on field trip day, Mr. Cowabunga's class wanted to go to the sandy floor. But instead of going to the sandy floor, they ended up on the candy floor. They got their swimsuits on, their suntan lotion ready, and they pulled the lever for the sandy beach to come out. But instead, candy came out, and tons of it. Orange Tic Tacs, to be exact. It was so unexpected. Mr. Cowabunga tried to turn the lever off, but instead pulled the candy lever all the way down. Mr. Cowabunga's class was covered in candy. The classroom was filled all the way up to the ceiling with orange Tic Tacs, and the whole class was trapped underneath. I called together the rest of the students to help save Mr. Cowabunga's class. I knew that no one could be lazy if we were going to save the class. Everyone was gonna have to work hard. I reminded everyone of Mrs. Wise's wise words. Proverbs 13:4, the lazy will not get what they want, but those who work hard will. So we grabbed all the sporks from Chef Cook's kitchen and we started digging and digging and we dug and dug and dug. But it almost seemed pointless because those sporks were no match for all those Tic Tacs. We wondered if all of our work would even make a difference. But after 7 hours of digging, the giant mound of Tic Tacs started to crumble. Then we saw the tops of students' heads popping out of the candy. Mr. Cowabunga's class was saved. Since everyone worked hard, there was an amazing reward. We saved Mr. Cowabunga's class, and everyone that helped was given a lifetime supply of Tic Tacs. Which was awesome, because that meant that we had plenty of supplies to play one of my favorite games ever, Tic-Tac-Attack. Well, sorry, I have to leave. I need to finish my laps before it's feeding time for the sharks. See you later.
time for the Sharks. I don't know if I want to stick around for that because I don't know if you've noticed, but I've been told that I kind of give off the smell or the odor of like shark bait. Ooh, ha, ha.
I don't know what shark food smells like, but phew, you sure give a distinct smell.
Oh, man, there's the sun. Let's get back. We got to get out of here. I don't want to end up shark lunch.
Now, you're the one who needs to calm down. The elevator will move once the lights flicker.
Two, gotta go. Oh, hold on, man. Hold on. Man, that was close. That was insane.
Yeah, but you know what, Zippy? What Mr. Wright was talking about kind of got me thinking because we had a horrible attitude of hard work while the people rescuing Mr. Cowabunga's class had a great attitude about it.
Yeah, I know what you're saying. I mean, we were even complaining about the work that we had to do at home, let alone here. But guess what we learned today? We learned that if you work hard today, man, there are awesome rewards for that hard work.
Speaking of rewards, I think we should try Mr. Wright's game of tic-tac-attack.
Ooh, I love tic-tac-attack. You know who we need up here? We need that girl from last week who thought there were 51 states. Maya, come on
up. Oh, and that girl who thought the green light was on top?
Oh, yeah. Gianna, come on up. We got this. All right, so we know your name's Maya, but how many states are there? Still, 51.
Yeah.
Rock on. All right. Green light. Up top, down below, in the middle.
On the bottom.
Okay, on the bottom. All right, so if I hope you guys can shake your head better than you can retain 50 states and green light all over. You're right. All right, so what we're going to go for is this is called tic-tac-attack. Now, what you do, do you have the tic-tacs?
Yeah, of course. I always come to school prepared.
All right, so here's what's going to happen. You guys are going to hold these tic-tacs, and they've been sanitized, don't worry. All right, you're going to hold these tic-tacs in your mouth. Let me open this one. Hold it in your hand for me. There you go. You're going to put this thing in your mouth, like that. All right, and then you're going to shake your head back and forth until all the tic-tacs are out of the container. All right? So before we get going, I need y'all's help at home. We're gonna count backwards from three, and when we get to one, we're gonna say attack, and that's when you guys go. First place gets a prize, second place gets a second place.
Good job.
All right, count with me. Three,
two, one, attack!
Shake, 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 shake!
Oh, that's in my eye!
Slobber. Oh, that's good. Keep going. Keep
going! Woo! Another one!
Oh!
Hey!
Oh, who's gonna get it?
Why are we wasting these?
Oh! Gianna's the winner! Good job! Hey, what prize do we have for Gianna?
We have a huge Hershey chocolate bar.
Ooh, that's good. And for Maya, we got an elbow because it's Corona time. There we go. All right, you guys take a seat. Good job, that was awesome. Man, it is so good that they weren't being lazy, that they were putting in the hard work to shake their heads backwards and forth, because if not, they wouldn't have had a chance to win the prize.
I know, and we get free Tic Tacs, but we get free Tic Tacs. Whoa.
So here's what I was thinking. I was thinking, since we've been working hard all day, and now it's time to go because, I mean, it's that time to go. When you're working hard, time flies. But I was thinking, time to go.
Woo!
It's awesome. All right. I know we've been working hard, but do you think that you could beat me in a race down to the first floor?
You're on.
All right. I'll count us down. All right. When we get to one, three, two, what is that? One, go!
Wait, no, you always do that. You know, this is why I should be counting down, not you. I hope Ms. Wise gives you detention.
Well, I don't know about you, but I would think that it would be so cool to have an aquarium in my school.
Yeah, that's totally true. Yeah, except I'm not too sure about that whole shark thing.
Okay, yeah, that's true. I don't really like sharks either.
Yeah.
But I think it's time for us to kind of see if everybody remembers what happened today. So let's see. Okay.
It's good quiz time, right?
Yeah. So Jordan and Zippy, did they really want to work hard at first? Yeah, not so much at first. No. But what happened when they did start to work hard? Yeah, that's right. They got a field trip to the aquarium.
That's right. So they got rewarded, right? So that's really kind of a cool thing. Hey, listen, parents, this might be a great time to talk to your kids about what working hard in your life looks like and maybe how God has really blessed you from that hard work. And then maybe also talk to the kids with some scenarios that they would relate to. Like, for example, let's say, guys, okay, you really want that video game, right? All your friends have it. You want it. It's kind of expensive, though, kind of thing. So let me ask you a question. If you just sat around or maybe just really, 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 really hoped for it really hard, would the money show up to buy the video game? No, right?
But if you were to work really, really hard at your chores and maybe even asked your neighbors or your grandparents if you could do something for them,
that's good.
Then could you possibly earn the money to pay for the game? Yeah, that's right. You definitely could do that.
That's exactly it. And that's what we're talking about, to work hard. Remember, because we're talking about how we live a wise life, to wise up and live the best life possible. And to do that, we need to follow Jesus, learn from his words, and live it out. And so what we want to say is, guys, this week, especially this week, and really all our lives, in whatever we do, let's do it to the fullest that we can. Let's work hard and make sure that we give it our all, including as we try to follow Jesus and reading our Bibles and praying and everything else. Let's make sure that we do it to the best of our ability. And then we can wise up and live the best life possible. All right, guys, it's been a great week. Thank you so much for joining us. Hope to see you again here next week on Aloma Kids Live.
And don't forget that this Thursday, July 30th, from 5 to 7, is our Aloma Kids drive-thru, and everybody better be there. That's right, you in the back that I'm looking at.
We see you. Come on, drive up. We'll see you here Thursday, too. All right, guys, we'll see you later.